Parakofei Pusik Tezvov. The Torah tells us that the male who was killed by Pinchas was Zimri, who was a Nossi, who was a prince. Vishem Isha Amukor. The name of the woman who was smitten, Hamidyonis, who was the Midianite, Cosby Basur. Her name was Cosby, the daughter of Tzur, Rosh Umos, Beisav Midian, who he was from the head, her father was the head of the most prestigious family of the Midianites. She was a princess. So Rashi over here points out, why is the Torah telling us who she was? Shem Isha Muko, Lo Diacho Sinosa Shel Midianim, to inform us to what degree the Midianites, their intense hate towards the Jews, Shefkir Bas Melech Luznus, they allowed the princess, they availed of his nus for this level of licentiousness, Kdei Lachdis Yisrael. At all costs, they were going to cause the Jews to sin. Meaning they understood that Zimri, being a prince, he's not going to be involved with any non-Jewish woman. But because she's a princess, this will ensnare him. And once Zimri follows, leads the pack, people follow. So they were willing to give the princess that she should be violated by a Jew to cause the other Jews to sin. Because Bilam, what he advised them that the only way could destroy the Jews is through licentiousness. Was Elokeim shall Yisrael soni zima, because the God of the Jews will not tolerate this kind of behavior. So the only way you could get the Jews to get involved, you have to start with the leadership. So if Zimri will get involved, the only one who's able to seduce Zimri, you have to have a princess. So because of the level of hate, they were even willing to allow the princess, who represents the ultimate of pedigree among the Midianites, as long as the Jews sin. I was just thinking, as I'm reading Rashi, Bullock believed that since the Jews killed Og and Sichon, who are the protectors of the nations of Canaan, if we don't stop the Jews, they will destroy all of us. As he had said to Bilam, as when the ox grazes, wherever it grazes, nothing grows afterwards. It becomes desolate. If the Jews pass by us, even the ones who won't be destroyed, they will actually bring about a level of desolation that you can never recover. That was the only reason why he commissioned Bilam. So it wasn't because he hated. It wasn't because he hated this intense hate. It was a question of survival, right? That's the way he explained it to Bilam. The reason why they were so overwhelmed with fear, because it was a question of now or never. If we don't stop them now, it's over. Because when they saw that the protectors of Canaan were destroyed by the Jews, the only one who could stop them is only Bilam, because his power lies in his mouth. It's not his physical might. So where we see, Cosby was the daughter of Bullock. So allowing his daughter to be defiled, it doesn't indicate the intense hate. Wasn't the intense hate of the Midianites that they're willing to give their princess to be defiled? It's a question of survival. You can't survive unless that you do what you have to do. But Rashi says that the Torah tells us that the woman who was given over, Cosby Bas Tzur, although she was a princess, that they're willing even to give the princess to be defiled, because that indicated the hate they had for the Jews. It's not a question of hate. It's a question of survival. So how does this indicate what Rashi is saying, which is the name of Chazal, that this is Sinosa Shel HaMidyonim, that they were willing to give even their princess?
Rabbi, could I add,
if
the learning could be in the merit of my mother this morning?
Again, Night Hill.
If the learning could be in the merit of my mother's yard site today.
Today's the yard site?
Yeah, Shavasim Batamas.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah.
It's Sor Roizel Bas Gittel.
Sor Roizel Bas Roizel?
Roizel.
Sor Roizel Bas Gittel.
Bas Gittel.
Shem Shrev Naliyah, Mitzah Shem.
Thank you.
The exclusive of the learning, besides for other reasons. Mitzah Shem. The question is, Midian wouldn't have been destroyed. Midian wouldn't have been destroyed. This paranoia, or it's not a paranoia, that Balak got involved here, it wasn't his fight. The Jews were going to destroy the nations of Canaan had nothing to do with Midian was going to be destroyed. So that he commissioned Bilam to curse us, that itself, that concern had to do because he felt for the Canaanites. We've seen the Oz Yoshir that when the nations of Canaan heard that the Mitzrim were destroyed in the Yamsuf, it says Yiguzun, Yoshi Ploshes. The word rogas means anger. They were angered. What was the anger? They were angered that through the Jews, the Egyptians were destroyed. There was an anger. What do you mean there's an anger? They enslaved us. They wanted to kill us. So why are they angered? Because due to the Jew, the Egyptians were destroyed. That only indicated the hate they had for the Jews. Otherwise, why are you angered? Over here, that Balak got involved here, he didn't have to get involved. The answer is because he had a sinner. As a result, what happened with where the Jews are coming from, where they're going, where did the Jews have the audacity, have the right to go with, but it's not your fight. It's not your fight. But if a person has hate, it becomes your fight. The anti-Semite, although he's not relevant to the whole discussion, but nevertheless, because he has that innate hate, automatically his behavior demonstrates that hate. So over here, that Balak gave his daughter to cause the Jews to sin, to that degree, that only indicated the intensity of hate. Because he understood the only way that the Jews will get involved, the leadership has to get involved. And that Zimri ben Solu, he was the prince of the tribe of Shimon. The Kisim Osam. How does he interpret the word soror?
Antagonize.
Harass. Yeah.
Harass. And then smite them. I mean, he could have said, just smite them. I mean, you have to feel the negativity towards them to be able to smite. It's hikisim, so say hikisim. Hikisim, so what's soror? You know, there's a concept, you know? Forgive, forget and forgive. You have to feel and sense the negativity towards them before you're able to smite them. You know, there's a famous discussion of the mitzvah Schiris Bechiyas HaMolik, the famous chinuch. The chinuch says that a woman is not obligated in Schiris Bechiyas HaMolik. Why? Because the value of remembering what HaMolik did to us is only so we should destroy them. And since Noshim Lavendos Mechoma, since the woman does not go to war, and she will not be the one to kill them. It's only the males. So you're only remembering, because if you forget what they did to us, you're not going to have that intensity of hate to be able to destroy them. So you have to remember exactly what they wanted to do to us when they attacked us. When we left Egypt, only then will you have that negative feeling enough to destroy them. Again, you have to have that negative feeling towards them, to harass them, to see them, to antagonize them. And as a result of that, you'll be able to destroy them. So the tzoror is like the prerequisite for the hikisem. Why? Yitzorim hem lochem. Because they themselves antagonized you b'nichleim through the machinations and nichlu lochem al vapor. They drew you in with the balpor. And the incident with Cosby, the daughter of the prince of Midian, their sister, who was smitten on the day of the plague of Vapor, because of the incident of the Balpor. So Rashi says something here. Quoting Chazal, Shifkiru binoseyem lisnus. They availed their daughters for this znus. Remember, I mentioned the women, they were beautiful women. They seduced the men, and the men couldn't control themselves. And when they wanted to engage sexually with them, they said, wait. They pulled out the idol and said, first you have to worship the poor. And only then they allowed them to engage with them. So the whole idea of the women enticing the men was only to bring him to the point that they should cross that line of Balpor, which is idolatry. Now the question is, why was it Moav? Why did they destroy Moav? Because Rus had to be born from the Moav, and there had to be a Rus in the future. Therefore, they were not commanded to destroy Moav. So Moav was saved because of who? Because there had to be a Rus. If there wouldn't have to be a Rus, Moav would have been destroyed. But because there had to be a Rus, they were spared. But they were no less culpable. We find something identical by the story of the Migdal Bovel. They rebelled against God. What did God do? He dispersed them and he instituted 70 languages. Each family spoke a different language. As a result of that, this caused their project to be disrupted. So Rashi over there asks, name of Chazal, why weren't they destroyed? Hashem should have destroyed them. You rebel against God, he should have destroyed them. So he says that because Avram Avinu had to be born from one of these families, and they were involved in the rebellion against God, so God spared them all because Avram had to come from Shem, was the descendant from Shase, was the son of Noah. And since they were part of this rebellion against God, if he would have destroyed them, there wouldn't have been an Avram. So he spared all 70 because there had to be an Avram. He spared Moab because there had to be a Rus, although they deserved to be destroyed. Literally, exactly identical. So the question is, he should have destroyed the others and left that family that was going to descend from, that Avram was going to descend from them. The answer is no. If there's an Avram, you have to have the counterforce. It's always 70 and the one. The world is 70 nations. Klal Yisrael is the 71st nation. That's the counterbalance. If there does not be an Avram, destroy them all. But if once there's an Avram, you have to have the 70, because that's the counterbalance to Avram. Regarding Moav, Why was Moab spared? Midian has nothing with Moab. Midian is culpable. Moab is culpable. Each one is culpable for the same reason. Midian can be destroyed. Moab can't be destroyed because if you destroy Moab, there's no Rus. And if there's no Rus, there's no David of Melech. Understand the difference. When the neshama has to be born into existence, if you remember, the Rechaim in the portion of Kiseitze speaks about Eishes Yifas Tor. If you go to war and you attract it to a beautiful woman, you permit it to take her as a wife. So there he explains, based on the Zohar, the Orachayim Kodesh, that after the Chet of Adam, when he ate of the tree of knowledge, because he asked questions. First of all, who goes to war? We're talking about the greatest tzaddikim, right? We read in Shoftim that when they're before they go out to war, they said a man who built a house, a man who was married, a man who's concerned that he's not worthy of protection. So only the most righteous went to battle, the tzaddikim. I mean, a tzaddik is attracted to a woman out on the battlefront. We're talking about she's not even Jewish. And says, Eishes Yifas Tor, meaning she could be as ugly as sin. But if he's attracted to her, he takes her. And then there's a 30-day process. If after 30 days she's still interested and he's interested, he marries her and he converts us to be Jewish. And it's not an ordinary conversion. She's almost forced to become, to convert. Normally a conversion, we have to see her level of sincerity. Eishes Yifas Tor, you don't need that. So he explains over there that after the Chet of Adam, and this evil was introduced, Sotom, the Sitra Achra, captured very special neshamos. One of the most special neshamos he captured was the neshama of Rus HaMovia. And the times during the history of existence where these neshamos could escape from the clutches of Sotom, from the Sitra Achra. So when the people in the battlefield, the tzaddikim, if they automatically feel an attraction to a woman, we're not talking about the physical attraction. There's something they sense is special about this person. So the question is it valid or not valid? So you undergo the process that you bring her back. She cries for the past, whatever it is. And if you're not interested, you send her off. And if you're interested, that means that is confirmation she has that special soul. That this is one of the souls that Sutton had captured. As he says, as Rusa Melvia was that special neshama. And the story with Boaz, with Naomi, and the whole story, that was an opportunity for her to be released, and that's how she converted. And ultimately, she was the grandmother of David HaMelech. That's the Arachaim over there in Parshas Kiseitze. This special neshama, she'd have to be a Moabite. If this soul had to be born and was going to be released, it could have come from another nation. It says the reason why Moab wasn't destroyed because Rus had to be born from Moab. Why did she have to be born from Moab? If the soul had to come to exist, she could have come in from some other nation. The answer is because Balak had built, like you mentioned before, he built all the altars. He brought those karbonos. So Balak was deserving of something special. What was he deserving? That Rus HaMovia, that special soul, should descend from him. That he should bring through his progeny, that soul should come to existence. As a result of that, the reason why she was locked into Moab is because of Balak. He told Shlo Shema Bal Lishma. As a result of that, that's why all Moab was destroyed. If Balak wasn't deserving of having Rus to be his descendant, she could have come from another nation. And because of what they did, they would have been destroyed. But because Balak had chosen to build those altars and bring those korbanos, although it was Shlo Lishma, it was only to destroy the Jewish people. It doesn't make a difference. But those karbonos were brought for Hashem. As a result of that, he was meritorious. For that merit, he deserved Rus. Once he deserves Rus, we can't destroy Moav, because if we destroy Moav, there's no Rus.